If you want to save some money on Bitwig Studio and the upgrade plans, and you want to support my channel and my content, then go to my webpage, use the link to the Bitwig store, use my code and save 10% on the regular price. Welcome back to another video. Today it's about the Smart Reverb by Sonnable. It's a company from Austria, and they created this plugin to actually create rooms specifically for your input sound. So I got this, I got the free license last Friday, so I tried this out over the weekend. I haven't much time, but this video is not really a review. It's more like kind of a show off ad thing where I want to show you what it does and how it sounds. So yeah, that's just about the meta information about this video. So this is the website here, sonnable.com/smartreverb, and you can actually download a trial version. It works for the 30 days, so you can try and hear it for yourself, try it out and find out if it's something you can use in your daily production life. Smart Reverb delivers custom tailored reverb by adjusting its processing to the individual characteristics of the input material and creates a navigable range of styles from scratch. That sounds pretty interesting. So switch to Bitwig, and inside Bitwig I have a piano sound. I think there's already room here on this. Maybe use up close. So this sounds pretty dry. And then we add here a smart reverb. And yeah, you can resize the interface up to twice the size, which is nice. And then you have some kind of default room as a default init setting. And to create a special room for your input sound, you have to press this analyze button here. You can see nothing happens, so you have to play a sound actually. So it listens to your input. And now it creates here, yeah, a special room with a special character made for your input sound. And all it does is basically it changes the character of the reverb. It doesn't change here the reverb time. You can change this all the time. It only changes here this matrix, basically. You can then step in and use here this X and Y pad to nudge it in some direction you want. So rich, natural, intimate, or artificial. Maybe we make this reverb time a bit longer so we can hear how the reverb sounds, the reverb tail sounds. So when we, for instance, here remove the dry signal, only leave the wet signal and make a pretty short room. So maybe a small club or something. So all you hear now is basically only this plugin. There's no dry signal. And then we have here these three options: width, color, and clarity. Clarity is basically something like a spectral balance, where you can remove some resonances in the post. And this color, which is some kind of an post EQ, where you can darken the sound or brighten the sound. Then you can use here the freeze and the infinite option to make some kind of drones. So this goes on basically forever. And then you have this multi-stage envelope here where you can change decay times over time, the stereo spread and the density. And you have on the bottom here actually some kind of post EQ, or I think it's a pre EQ actually. Gain for the first filter band. I think it's a pre EQ. I'm not sure about this, but you have some kind of EQ inside here at least. But I think where this plugin really shines, in my opinion, or in my short time of testing this, is drum sounds. Because I have a lot of problems actually with reverbs on drum sounds, because you get a lot of resonances when you have short reverb times because of the feedback algorithm of most of these artificial reverbs. But here you can remove all the resonances. You get only stereo information if you want. So let's go here completely dry. So maybe use your completely, yeah, just actually use this rim shot here and make this pretty short. So we have all, so we have no tail whatsoever. So let's try and create a reverb tail of this rim shot here with this smart reverb. So first analyze. Okay, so now blend in the wet signal, maybe blend out the dry signal and make it intimate. So you can kind of create tails for pretty short sounds that sound believable. I think that's where I want to use this plugin most of the times, so actually on percussion sounds. But maybe, as you just saw on piano sounds, it also sounds nice and you can create nice drones. So I have to try this out more, but for now it's pretty interesting. It sounds weird and nice at the same time, I think. So maybe go to the website, give it a try it out for yourself, and just download the try version. So that's it for this video. I want to show you this plugin that came out today, and that's it basically for this video. So from now on, there are also some membership options below all my videos here on YouTube. I also made a video about this recently. So you don't need actually to go to Patreon and subscribe there. You can also subscribe now on YouTube itself. So if you want to support my content and my videos, then maybe think about a membership or subscription there. It's pretty helpful actually. Also, if you liked the video, then please leave a like, subscribe to the channel, and thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye.